Hi Squirts, welcome back! Today we're going to be reading Walt Disney's Lady and the Tramp. So let's get started. Jim Deere and his wife, Darling, were celebrating Christmas Eve. "Here, Darling," he said, handing her a pretty box. Darling untied the ribbon, and out popped the most adorable Cocker Spaniel puppy she had ever seen. "I love her," Darling explained happily. "She is the perfect lady." When Lady was 6 months old, Darling and Jim Deere gave her a brand new collar and name tag. "How fine you look in your new collar, Lady," Darling said. That night, as usual, Jim Deere tucked Lady into her very own basket. Lady was the princess of the household. Jim Deere and Darling loved to pamper her. They gave her special treats from the table, and they always found time to play with her. Lady was sure that she was the luckiest dog in the whole wide world. But as spring blossomed and into summer, Jim Deere and Darling began to play with Lady less and less. Now they spent most of their time talking about someone named Baby. "Who is this Baby?" "A baby is nothing but a bundle of trouble," said a husky voice. Lady whirled around to see who was speaking. It was a scruffy-looking dog she had never seen before. Why, he wasn't even wearing a collar. "By the way, Pidge," he said, "my name is Tramp. What's yours?" "I'm sorry," replied Lady, "but I never speak to strangers."
"Suit yourself," said Tramp. "But mark my words," he called out as he trotted by, "when a baby moves in, a dog moves out."
A short time later, Lady heard new sounds coming from the master bedroom. Soft, cooing sound. "Come in, Lady," Darling said gently. "There's someone I'd like you to meet." "So this is what a baby looks like," thought Lady, wagging her tail happily. "He's not awful at all. Why, he's almost as sweet as a puppy." Soon life in Lady's household had almost returned to normal. But one day, a stern-looking woman barged through the front door carrying a suitcase and a big basket. "We're going away for a few days," Darling explained to Lady, "and we're counting on you to take good care of the baby. Aunt Sarah here has come to help you." Two pairs of blue eyes stared at Lady from the basket.
"I wonder what she has in there," said Lady.
Soon she found out the eyes belonged to Aunt Sarah's cats, Cy and Am. The two cats hopped out of the basket and made themselves at home.
"We are Siamese, if you please."
"We are Siamese, if you don't please."
Lady got the feeling that Cy and Am didn't like her. And for some reason, Aunt Sarah didn't seem too friendly either. Lady watched sadly as Darling and Jim Deere walked out the door.
"Oh, please don't leave me here alone," she said softly.
Aunt Sarah went upstairs to check on the baby. As soon as the mischievous cats saw her leave, they began to turn the house upside down. "Stop that," Lady barked angrily. She really had her paws full trying to keep the goldfish and the canaries safe from harm. When Aunt Sarah saw the terrible mess, she was sure it was all Lady's fault.
"You naughty dog,"
Aunt Sarah scolded as she chased Lady from the house with a grin.
Poor Lady, she had never been so insulted in all her life.
Upset, she walked out of the yard. Lady didn't pay attention to where she was going, just as long as it was far away from Aunt Sarah as possible. It wasn't long before Lady found herself on the other side of town. She was far from her home and the well-mannered dogs, who were her friends. Suddenly, Lady heard the angry growls of a pack of vicious dogs. To her surprise, they began to chase her. But before they could harm Lady, Tramp showed up to save the day. "Why don't you pick on someone your own size instead of bothering the lady?" Tramp shouted at the pack of dogs. Tramp fought like a tiger, but when he was through, those bullies couldn't run fast enough. Lady thanked Tramp for rescuing her,
Then she told him all about her troubles with Aunt Sarah and the wicked cats.
Poor Pidge, said Tramp. How about a nice hot meal to cheer you up? He suggested.
He brought Lady to the best Italian restaurant in town.
What a nice surprise, cried Tony the chef, when Tramp appeared at the back door.
Tony was so delighted to see Tramp with such a lovely lady that he brought out a big plate of spaghetti and meatballs for the two dogs to share. He even serenaded them with his accordion.
This is wonderful, Lady said to herself. She gazed fondly at Tramp.
He's not so bad after all, even if he doesn't have a collar.
After dinner, Tramp took Lady for a romantic stroll through the park.
That night, the two dogs fell asleep under a full moon.
Oh, dear, cried Lady the next morning. I should have been home hours ago.
Ah, forget the rules for once, replied Tramp. There's a whole big world out there for us to explore.
But who will watch over the baby?
Asked Lady. You win, said Tramp. I'll take you home.
Their walk was quite pleasant until Tramp spotted a hen house. His eyes lit up at once.
Chickens, he cried. Ever chase chickens, Pidge?
It's fun.
Before Lady could stop him, Tramp ran into the midst of the clucking hens.
Stop, shouted Lady, but Tramp was having too much fun to stop, until the owner of the hen house called the dog catcher.
Run, Lady, run,
called Tramp as he sped away. He thought Lady was right behind him, but Lady wasn't fast enough. As she rounded the corner, the dog catcher nabbed her and threw her into his wagon. Tramp had no idea what had happened to her. Before she knew it, Lady was behind bars in the city pound. She was so ashamed.
What are you in for, sweetheart?
Laughed Bull, the bulldog.
Putting fleas on the butler?
Luckily, a dog named Boris told Lady that she had nothing to fear.
Dogs with name tags never stay here long, he explained.
Sure enough, early the next morning, one of the guards came and took Lady to her home. But Aunt Sarah was still upset, so she chained Lady up outside. Soon, Tramp, who had been searching for Lady all night, came cranching into her yard.
Pidge, he explained happily. I've been so worried.
Don't call me Pidge, snapped Lady. This is all your fault. I never want to see you again.
Lady felt sad and lonely. She had promised Darling that she would protect the baby, but how could she do her job if she was chained up outside?
Soon it was dark. Lady tossed and turned, but she could not fall asleep.
Suddenly she noticed something moving. It was a huge rat, and it was heading straight for the house.
Lady watched in terror as the rat climbed onto the roof and through the baby's window.
Woof, 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 she cried.
Tramp came running when she heard her bark.
A rat, she cried.
In the baby's room. Tramp rushed into the house. Lady managed to break her chain and follow him. Together, they ran into the baby's room.
Tramp quickly pounced on the rat, and they began to fight.
Tramp and the rat rolled around on the floor, knocking over lamps and chairs. Finally, though, Tramp won.
Wah, wah, wah,
wailed the baby, who was frightened by all the noise. Aunt Sarah was awakened by the baby's cry.
Shoo, she cried.
Get back, you brute.
Down to the cellar with you.
Aunt Sarah wasted no time in calling the dog catcher. And for the first time in his life, Tramp found himself on his way to the pound. Lady watched sadly as the wagon pulled away. Just then, Jim Deere and Darling arrived home.
What's going on here? Asked Jim Deere.
I found a stray dog in the baby's room, explained Aunt Sarah. And your dog here was right beside him. With that, Lady began to bark and headed up the stairs.
Stop her! Squealed Aunt Sarah. She'll hurt the baby.
Nonsense, Jim Deere replied. She's trying to tell us something. Lady led them all to the dead rat that lay hidden behind the chair in the baby's room.
Merciful heavens!
Exclaimed Aunt Sarah.
Good dog,
said Jim Deere, giving Lady a hug. You did your job well, girl, just as I knew you would. But what about that other dog?
asked Jim Deer. He was brave, too. Let's see if we can stop the dog catcher before he gets to the pound. Jim Deer and Lady hurried outside. They hopped into a taxi and sped after the dog catcher's wagon. When they finally called up to the wagon, Jim Deer explained to the dog catcher that Tramp didn't belong in the pound.
You really like this tough guy, don't you? Jim Deer asked Lady.
Well, why don't we invite him to come and live with us? He added. Lady smiled at Tramp. Then she wagged her tail and let Jim Deer know she thought this was a splendid idea. It took some getting used to, but Tramp grew to love being part of a family. Jim Deer and Darling grew to love him, too. It wasn't long before he had a collar and a name tag of his own. When Christmas Eve rolled around, again, Lady and her Tramp had some very special presents under the tree. Not one, not two, not even three, but four adorable puppies of their own. The end, guys. All right, Squirts, thank you for coming and watching and listening. I hope to see you again.